Hi friends, welcome to the new series JavaScript Zero to Hero. In this series, I'm going to explain all the basic concepts in JavaScript. In this video, I'm going to give a short introduction on JavaScript. What is JavaScript? JavaScript is a text-based programming language, in other words, a scripting language. JavaScript follows ECMA standard, and ECMAScript is the official name of JavaScript. There are many versions like ES1, ES2, ES3, ES5, and ES6. ES4 was also there, but it met with a bunch of controversies and was not having sufficient support for browsers, and so it got abandoned. And ES5, which was released in 2009, was the first main revision. And then ES6, which was released in 2015, was the second revision, and it got so many new features. JavaScript can be used in both client and server side. To develop your website, we need HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. HTML gives the structure of the website. CSS adds styles and make it beautiful. Using JavaScript, we can make the website dynamic. We can create and change content dynamically. We can animate text and images. We can play video in websites. Not only these, we can implement many complex features using JavaScript. Let's create our first JavaScript. Let me create one HTML file first and create the basic HTML structure. And let me have a H1 tag inside. And let me also open this HTML page. Okay, I can see this. To this HTML page, I can add the JavaScript using a script tag. So inside head section, let me add a script tag. Inside this script tag, I can write JavaScript tag. Let me write an alert. So if I refresh, we can see the alert. I can also add the script tag inside the body. Like this. If I refresh, we can see this too. But what is the difference between adding in head and body? Assume I want to show the text present inside the H1 tag in the alert. I can show it like this. But if I put this code in the head section, it won't work. Let me show that. If I inspect, we can see this error. Cannot read properties of undefined. This is because the execution happens from top to bottom. By the time we are trying to get the element, it's not created in the DOM, and so it is undefined. But at this point, the element has created, and so it is working. And so, usually, if we are dealing with DOM, we put the script just before the closing body tag. This is one way of adding JavaScript. If we have a lot of JavaScript, it will be difficult to maintain in the same file. In that case, we can go for external JS. Instead of putting the code inside the script tag like this, I can use a source attribute and refer an external JS file. Let me also create that file. And I can put this code here. If I refresh, we can see it is working. The advantage of using like this is, it is easy to maintain because we are separating the JavaScript code from the HTML code. Also, after we load the site once, this JS file will be cached, and so next time it loads faster. But the disadvantage is, in this approach, there will be an additional HTTP call to download this JavaScript file. But that is not a big problem. Hope you understand what is JavaScript, why we need that, and how we can use it in our website. If you like this video, please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.